there's nothing more precious than a healthy, happy child. They are the heart of every home. But when a family first hears that their child has a brain tumor, their entire world changes in an instant.
The moment that we find out, it was crazy. It was just like it went from 0 to 60 incredibly fast of, okay, something's a little off, to we need to go to the emergency MRIs. What our pediatrician said, like, you need to go now and you need to get her checked out. I just remember waiting and then coming out with the nurses sitting really close to us. You know, they came into the room and you could just tell on their face something was wrong and if something was serious. I was holding some yellow Play-Doh, and that's when they told us that our daughter had a large tumor on the back of her brain. We were trying to be our own doctors, and Googling brain cancer in children is very scary, just because brain cancer is the leading cause of death in children, and that's what we were facing.
I remember feeling a lot of shame or frustration that, did I miss something? But I knew if we did the next right thing, if we, you know, found the right care team, we could have hope.
We originally started PNOC because others weren't doing therapeutic trials in an efficient, bold way. And that hadn't changed over 15 or 20 years at least. And it hadn't changed the outcome of kids over the last 40 or 50 years in terms of the most deadly of the pediatric brain cancers that we treat. We needed a new group of people to get together to strategize how to move things faster, quicker, and more efficiently, and to take some risks.
And so we started to ask the question, how can we innovate around how we conduct clinical trials around imaging and other biomarkers to better evaluate these patients on our clinical trials? So we spent the last 12 years building a global, internationally collaborative network.
That effort became PNOC, a global network of more than 300 of the world's top researchers and clinicians, who span across 42 institutions worldwide to achieve breakthrough therapies for pediatric brain cancer.
PNOC is not just about finding more effective drug or drug combinations. It's about examining the whole framework of treating our patients.
In order to foster rapid translation from the bench to bedside, it was very important to us that we share any data that we can share in real time with the research community at large.
One of the trials that hopefully will be upcoming in PNOC is that we're investigating use of laser ablation. You know, traditionally when we have to do a big incision, we take out the bone, we go and resect the tumor. Instead of doing that, we can actually just place multiple fibers that are about 1.6 millimeter wide and drill very small holes and make little tiny incisions that patients can't even see. As you can see here, there's this patient. What we plan to do is to place three lasers through different trajectories of the head. We're going to use a robotic arm that's calibrated through this machine to place the laser exactly where we want it to be. And once the laser is in place, we actually just heat the tip of the laser that will basically burn the tumor off, effectively doing the same thing that we're able to do with surgery. But instead, patient wake up, you know, as if nothing happened, and usually go home the next day or the day after.
The day Courtney had surgery, I remember meeting her surgeon after the 8-hour operation and seeing him and having him look us in the eyes, saying, it was successful, we got it all. It was like this incredibly overwhelming feeling.
After Courtney's surgery, and we were looking for ways that we could be involved and help give back as we were going through this experience and knowing other people are too. So we actually saw an article about PNOC in a local magazine, and it was like just serendipitous of opening this magazine up and seeing this great foundation, but also the doctors that helped save Courtney's life were the ones that were part of this foundation. And so we immediately jumped in.
Tell me a little bit, how are you doing these days? Is anything hurting you? No. On every PNOC protocol, every child undergoes frequent assessment of how they are feeling and how they are doing. Because as a child goes through treatment, we also have to take into consideration their quality of life. And this is a critical aspect in everything we are doing. When I see Courtney, this is obviously one of these highlights. These are the patients where our therapy and intervention led to a beautiful recovery from a child being very sick and had to be in the intensive care unit, It is just fantastic to see how she's thriving, and that's obviously the kind of outcome we wish for every of our patients.
June 1st, 2025 will be 4 years since surgery. She's doing great. I mean, she's a sassy, spunky, funny little five-year-old girl with a huge personality. We have a father-daughter dance tonight, our first one, so that'll be another milestone.
Despite everything Courtney's been through, she's thriving today. And so we want every child to have the same outcome that we've had. We want to lose no child to this disease.
The progress PNOC's made, even the 4 years we've been involved, has been astounding. And all these people are working incredibly hard to find that cure and find that solution for this horrible disease.
Our relentless pursuit has led to a landmark FDA drug approval. It's an oral medication so that families can take this drug at home. The disease that it targets is the most common brain tumors that we see, and it's been very effective in terms of the number of children that it's helped. So this has been a really amazing success story to bring something like this to so many children.
Kids with brain tumors don't have time for business as usual, neither do we. This year alone, we have an unprecedented 12 new clinical trials to launch.
Now we need your help to write the next chapter.
Lose No Child is a bold and urgent effort to raise $50 million in 5 years so that we can accelerate progress, transform treatments, advance research, and develop safer, more effective therapies for kids with brain cancer.
With your help, we can change the future of pediatric brain cancer now.
There's never been a more hopeful time in history to invest in pediatric brain cancer research.
Every child deserves to live their life to its fullest potential. Together, we can give every child the chance they deserve. Together, we can lose no child.